Baby.
Schrock Innovations presents the Midwest number one independent computer repair company with service centers in Lincoln, Omaha, Papillion, Des Moines, and across the country via the Schrock Desk. This is Compute This.
Good morning, folks, and welcome into Compute This. My name is Thor Schrock, and I'm the owner of the Schrock Innovations Computer Company with four service centers, as the big voice just told you. Lincoln, the original Schrock Innovations, just south of 14th and Pine Lake Road on, it's basically 15th and, it's two blocks south of 14th and Pine Lake Road. There you go. In Omaha, 168th and Burke Street, just across the street from the Village Point Mall, where the rent is slightly but not much cheaper. Then we have the Papillion Service Center in Midlands Place at 84th and Highway 370. Great little business park there. Just love it there. And then the brand new location, 9500 University Avenue in West Des Moines, Iowa. I have to say, you know, the more time that we spend in that West Des Moines community, the more amazing it is. We had a ribbon cutting last week with the West Des Moines Chamber of Commerce. And it's just good people. You know how you can, when you're in business, sometimes you meet with people and they're like, everybody wants something. They're a little schmarmy sometimes. You know, they're trying to sell you something. I mean, everyone in that room has a business. Everyone in that room has something they want to sell. And everyone in that room was there for a ribbon cutting. It was just awesome. It was just, that doesn't happen unless you have really good people. And so we're really thrilled to be in that West Des Moines community. It's just awesome. All right, so we got a really good show for you planned today, guys. If you missed the show last week, you missed a good one. Now, the show is available in our archives. You can listen to it at schrockinnovations.com. Or, of course, if you're watching right now on Facebook at facebook.com/schrockinnovations, you can scroll down a little bit there and you will see older videos, right? And the older videos are the ones from last week. In the middle there, there's another video that we did post to Facebook this week. I don't know about you guys, but I'm getting these ransomware email attack things in my inbox daily. Sometimes hourly, but daily at least. And so I decided finally, this is ridiculous because there's a certain percentage of people who are going to click on these links. So I went ahead and shot a video of what happens when you get the email. And literally, I clicked the links. I'm like, here's what happens when you click this link. Boom. And I showed you how even endpoint antivirus didn't stop me from clicking the links. It didn't stop me from going to the infected page. I stopped me right before I downloaded the infection to my computer, because that was the next step. And that's one of the reasons we're going to talk about the new upcoming transition to Sophos endpoint with its ransomware protection. The threatscape has changed, guys. I mean, it is the real deal. We have a story today on the show about Android malware, of all things, for your Android phone and tablet. But if you missed last week's show, last week we told you all about Huawei's shoddy security. It's not that the communists are, trying to steal data. It's just that They're not good at security, apparently, ironically, and their software is shoddy, and it's got lots of holes in it. And so the UK was like, increasingly we shouldn't use this. Ransomware gangs, we talked about them last week, shifting their tactics, asking for more money, and changing the way they attack you so that even if you have a backup of your files, you still have to pay the ransom. Also, Flash was end of life in December. We told you about that on the show so that you could be prepared for that when the time comes. Some people did ask us through email if we were planning on doing something with Secure Updater, because as you know, Secure Updater does support Flash. And so when Flash becomes, not okay to run, there's a couple things that we can do. And we're always really careful with this, because one of the things that we could do is we could programmatically remove Flash from your computer. We could send out an update for Flash that essentially uninstalls Flash because it's not safe to run it anymore. We could be like the authoritarian police and do that to you, and then every time you reinstall it, Secure Updater would just yank it out again. That's a great way to keep someone's subscription, by the way. Just repeatedly do things that they don't like. I don't know how Google does it. You repeat do things that people don't like, and then you expect people to continue to pay for or use your product. I have to tell you, I've been taking a look at DuckDuckGo as the search engine DuckDuckGo, and it's weird because we are in the SEO business. We are in the web optimization business, and we understand you have to play Google's game because most people use Google. But I'm just telling you, next time you do a Google search for something, it's really interesting. You do your Google search, and then open up another tab and do the exact same search on DuckDuckGo. Ads are the same. Results are completely different. I mean completely different. And it's just an interesting thing to watch. You can really see who's getting sandbagged and who isn't. Where the finger is on the scale, it's really easy to tell by comparing those two search engine results because they use very similar algorithms. This week coming up on the show, Windows 10, the new version, Windows 10 version 20H2, is coming within 14 days. So guys, time's almost up. We have 88 copies of Safe Upgrade remaining in the online store, so if you're interested in that, we'll tell you how to get that in a minute. But only 14 days to go. It's like a scary Halloween treat for you for your computer. Yay, trick or treat. Here's an update. New Android ransomware, as I mentioned, is hitting Android phones across the world right now, so we want you to know about that so you can be prepared for it and know what not to do, which is, of course, something that all of your kids are trying to do right now. We want to make sure you know about this. Also, there's a restaurant out there that employed one simple, well, I shouldn't say simple, but they bought a tech company. And you hear about these weird things where companies buy little tech companies. But McDonald's bought this little tech company and used their technology in their drive-thru, and they shaved 40 seconds off drive-thru time. So when you think about it, 40 seconds, you're like, oh, it's 40 seconds. It's not the end of the world. But most people spend about 370 seconds in the McDonald's drive-thru when they go through. You shave 40 seconds off that? That's huge. That's a lot more customers per day in the middle of a pandemic when you can only use the drive-thru. That's when they did it, by the way. So we're going to give you, honestly, there are those of us who eat at McDonald's and there are those of us who don't. And I am generally falling into the category of those who don't, although I do enjoy a delicious McGriddle from time to time. I don't know how they make the buns taste like syrup, but it's probably going to give me cancer. I don't know, but it's delicious. But what I'm going to tell you about, guys, is this is the story of what McDonald's needs to do to become the iconic fast food restaurant that it was in the 80s, in America in the 1980s. And it's stupid simple. It's really, really easy. And it's a lesson for every other business out there to learn as well. That there's one stupid trick that you can do to make your brand better. And improve your position in the marketplace. And we're going to tell you what that is coming up. And then finally, those of you who are in the investor class, you've heard them before say, Thor, I appreciate that stock tip. Man, that was great. I do not give stock tips. I do not give stock advice. I am not a financial advisor. If you choose to take your financial advice from the computer repair guy, then you choose to get the result that you get, okay? But I got a hot stock tip for you, disclaimer aside. And there's a company out there that's going to make our modular computers 26% faster before the end of this year. And that's somebody you're going to want to have a piece of, I'm going to tell you. It's going to be huge, and we're going to tell you all about that. So action-packed show coming up today. The benches and all the service centers are doing well. We're coming out of that summer slump, getting into the fall here. Some of the things that are happening, obviously, we have holiday special laptops coming into the service centers. Or I should say we have a holiday special laptop coming into one service center. This is our internal demo test evaluation model. It will be at the Papillion Service Center. I believe it is arriving on Tuesday. We're going to try it. And if we like it, it's going to become the holiday special laptop. In the meantime, we are also working on the holiday special desktop build. There is a processor shortage right now, which isn't helping anything. Those of you who like our Endeavor model computer with the Ryzen 3 chip, can't find those anywhere right now. They're selling for 70% over retail on eBay because nobody can find them anywhere. So we're desperately trying to find those. Anytime I can find them, I buy as many as I can to get them in. We'll tell you about the holiday special situation, what's going on there, what we think we're going to do, what that looks like. We're also going to discuss that a little bit in the aftershock today as well. But next week, one of the things we always do is we always look for testers. So we try to get three testers for each model so that we have a desktop and a laptop. And the three testers that we're looking for, we want a residential user, somebody who's going to use it for normal residential stuff. Then we want a business user. We want somebody who's going to use it for a home office application. And then we want a power user, somebody who's going to use it like with AutoCAD to make skyscrapers or something crazy. You know, we want to have somebody really push the computer. And then we have those people on the show to talk about their experience with the laptop. Now, the way that the testing works is you still pay full freight for the laptop. It's not a discount or anything. It's not like you're beta testing the laptop to see if we got it, if we hit it spot on. I mean, this is going to be the final product that you're ordering. But we want you to basically provide some social proof for us to let the listeners on the show know, because I can say it all day long. But if you say it, if you call in and say it, then it's totally different. People believe you more than me. I don't understand that. But, you know, whatever. It's because you're a good person. So basically, starting next week, we're going to be looking for testers for the holiday special laptop and desktop. The computers are $14.99, but when you purchase them, you will actually get yours early. There is some discussion inside the shop. We want to try to have them in stock. We really, really want to try to have them in stock so you can take them home that day. These computers are incredibly expensive, and they are, and the parts are hard to get right now. So when, for example, motherboards. When I can order motherboards, I order like 40 of them at a time. We don't need 40 at a time, but I order 40 at a time because I know the next two times I go to order, I won't be able to find a motherboard anywhere. So we got to make sure that we get them while we can. It's the same thing now with processors, the same thing with all kinds of stuff as far as computers go, the same thing with the holiday special laptops. So we really, really want to have them in stock because we usually sell 300 computers total for the holiday special, 150 laptops, and 150 desktops. And that's it. And then it's done. Well, guess what? I don't know if I'm going to be able to get 150 laptops. And I won't know until the day comes when I go to place an order and they say, sorry, we don't have any. So I got to stay ahead of the curve so that I don't sell someone a laptop and then end up not being able to get it. That would be bad. So we got to stay ahead of the curve, but how far ahead is the question? So basically, if you're interested in being a holiday special tester for our new computers that are coming out this holiday season, let us know in any of the service centers. We'll mark your name and number down and give you a call as soon as that opportunity is available. Be sure to let us know what kind of use you have in mind for the laptop as well or the desktop. The desktop is going to be a full home office Zoom capable interactive media broadcasting machine this year. I mean, literally, the entire computer is designed for that. It's funny, I read a story about Zoom is kind of concerned because they're not sure how they're going to experience any growth next year. And I'm like, well, wow. Post-pandemic, are we going to be Zooming more or less? Well, and then given that we hit peak Zoom this year, is there any more Zooming than any of us can do? I'm averaging 3 Zoom calls a day myself, and it's getting old, to be honest. But it's also nice because it allows me to meet with more customers than I could meet with before, more business owners than I could meet with before. So it's nice in that regard that I don't have all the lost travel time and everything else. And you know, whenever I go into the office, somebody always grabs me and pulls me aside with something, and it's crazy. The number to join us on the program today is 888-250-2091. Of course, if you ask a question or make a comment, we will put you in the drawing here for a $25 Schrock Innovations gift certificate that we'll give away at the end of the show. No purchase is necessary to enter that contest. All you have to do is give us a call. Now, one of the things I'll point out is people come into the service center and they say, Thor, I had this question, but I didn't want to call into the show. Let me explain something. If you have a computer question, there is no such thing as a silly question. Because if you have the question, tons of other people around you have the question as well. Here's a good example. We get a question all the time on the radio show. Should I have a VPN, a virtual private network, to protect my personal data, basically protect my identity when I'm online, so that nobody knows who I am or where I'm coming from? My answer in the historic past has always been, you know, they will protect your identity and everything, but there are some things that will also break. For example, when you have a VPN installed and you go to do a Google search, since Google can't figure out who you are if you're not signed into your Google account, they make you do a CAPTCHA where you have to say, I'm not a robot, and you have to pick out all the traffic lights in the picture or whatever, the fire hydrants. It's really annoying. So guess what? I use DuckDuckGo. Great. Google just keeps giving me that gentle push. I'm just like, gosh, you know, if you don't want me here, I get the feeling like you don't want a certain type of person here. You know, gee whiz. I'm one of the bad people, apparently. So anyway, the second part of that, though, is when you run that, if you log into your credit card, your bank account, you're coming from an unknown device at that point, or you're coming from an unknown location, or you're coming from Canada, and they're like, this is kind of fraudulent. We're going to put the kibosh on this, lock your account. So that's the downside. Infuriating Omaha World Herald paywall decided, finally pushed me over the edge. I'm like, literally, like, I have a subscription. I had a subscription. I canceled it. Who wants the newspaper, right? The digital subscription to the World Herald is some crazy amount of money. It's like $50 a quarter or something for an online newspaper. And I get it. I want the value of the journalism. I just don't think it's worth that much. Not that much, you know. You're talking $5-$10 a month? You know, sure. You know, I'll pay that. That's about how much I would pay for a newspaper if I was buying it out of the box. You know, you go. It's kind of like when you used to drive by the box. You know, at McDonald's in the drive-thru because it would take 40 seconds longer. You drive through that and you'd see the newspaper box. And there'd be a story on the front page of the newspaper, top fold, that would make you put your quarters in and buy the paper. That's how online newspapers are now, right? You go to the page and you're scrolling down the page and you're like, that story looks interesting, and you click on it. And then they give it to you for about 4 seconds and then they say, whoopsie, you gotta pay. So guess what? You put a VPN on your phone and suddenly you don't have to pay anymore. That is how you circumvent the Omaha World Herald pay firewall. 888. See, you learn new things all the time on the show. All you have to do is call and ask. 888-250-2091. I just made a lot of friends at the World Herald. I probably shouldn't have done that on the air. But anyway, and I honestly, like I said, guys, I value the journalism. I really do. But, I mean, I read maybe 4 stories a week. It's just not worth $50 a quarter for 4 stories a week. It's, to me, it's just not. If I was, you know, consuming the entirety of the content from one side of the site to the other every week, then yeah, I mean, it might be worth that. I just, to me, it's not, because I don't. 888-250-2091 is the number to join us on the program. Before we take our first break here, I want to remind everybody what's going on with the, and see, guys, I pushed it way back this time. Like, it's 14 days or so away, but the big Windows 10 2.0H2 update is coming down before the end of October. And when it comes down, it's going to be an overnight snap. It's gonna be like Thanos, okay? He's gonna snap his finger and half the computers on the planet are gonna stop working. I mean, it's just how it's gonna, it's not gonna be quite half. It'll be more like 20%. You know, the Microsoft finger snap is not Thanos. You know, they're missing a couple jewels or something. If you're a Marvel fan, you get it. But anyway, the long and the short of it is, guys, they're changing every single thing in the past that has caused a problem, but they're changing it all at the same time. And then they created a new delivery vehicle that instantaneously allows everyone on the planet to have it installed at the same time because it's already being installed on your computer, just not being turned on. So here's the challenge that we have. Many computers don't get tested for these updates. My seventh generation laptop that I have in front of me right now for the Facebook show was one of the ones that literally... Sometimes I take a computer like this that I just use for studio work and I just let it sit until Microsoft tells me it's time to update it. They told me it's time to install the 7-month-old update last week for my computer. Because I was one of the people that never got tested because I have a 3-year-old computer. They don't test that. So if you have a computer more than 18 months old, they don't test it against, you know, for you at all. And they're just going to install it on your computer and let it go. So that's why Safe Upgrade was created. Safe Upgrade is a product that installs this update the same way that our technicians would do it in the service center to make sure that you don't lose all your data, that your computer will reboot, that when it does reboot, that everything is the way it was supposed to be, and it doesn't just try to keep installing the update over and over and over, because that's what happens a lot of times. Safe Upgrade is available on our website. It's a digital product that you buy for $54.99. You can get it at schrockinnovations.com. You click on Shop and then Specials. And when you click on Shop and Specials, you're able to go ahead and order it. You need one for each computer you want to safely upgrade. So if you have 5, you want to order 5. We have 88 copies left as of the start of the program today. The other thing to keep in mind is if you purchased Safe Upgrade in the past, if you purchased it on for example, for the spring upgrade this year, or the H1 upgrade this year, that license is used. That was only for that upgrade. You need to buy the fall license for the fall upgrade. And then next spring, you'll have to buy that spring license for the 2021 upgrade. So you have to buy one for the computer each time if you want to use it. And if you would prefer to come into the service center, you can certainly do that. The thing that we're worried about this time, though, is because of the delivery mechanism, if you reboot your computer or if your computer reboots itself, you're going to get the update. It's going to be that quick this time. So it's really important that we make sure we reach all of you as quickly as possible and we get it done on time this go round. If you're going to be out of town or away from your computer, just turn it off when you leave. It won't install anything while you're gone. 888-250-2091. Got to take our break, guys. When we come back, David and Monica, your calls are coming up next on Compute This.
Schrock Innovations Data Recovery Lab saves the data the other guys can't. The next time your hard drive, camera card, or flash drive fails, let Schrock get your data back. External hard drives are handy. You can back up multiple computers to them or even use them to move lots of data from one computer to another. Computer users have been buying the same old external hard drives for years. While our computers have been getting faster, we still do backups that take hours or watch epic progress bars creep by to move files. Schrock wanted more for our customers, so our innovators created the fastest external hard drives on the planet. Schrock modular storage devices are up to 50% faster than Seagate or Western Digital externals and are modular in the truest sense of the word. We can create whatever size and speed of drive you need for all of your needs, and all modular storage devices come with a data restoration guarantee. If you use our drives for backing up and your computer's hard drive fails, we'll restore your backup to your repaired computer for free. Fast, simple, and flexible technology solutions from Schrock Innovations. It's what we do.
Compute This Pro Tip 299. There are enough mothballed computers in U.S. homes to give one to every man, woman, and child in the country. Many of these computers find their way into landfills where they can leak cadmium, lithium, and other nasty chemicals into the groundwater. Schrock Innovations is very proud of the fact that we recycle more e-waste every year than we create. You can drop off any old or broken computer equipment to our service centers at any time, free of cost. We only charge $15 just for monitors because they are especially difficult to process. No appointment is required, and we accept all computer-related equipment like printers, keyboards, speakers, and accessories. Additionally, the rare earth elements in computers can be recycled right here in the U.S. to reduce our reliance on supplies from foreign countries. Take a moment, drop off your old computer equipment today, and Schrock will make sure it's properly recycled and put to good use right here in the U.S. This pro tip brought to you by Schrock Innovations Computer Company.
Alrighty, folks, welcome back into Compute This. My name is still Thor Schrock, and I still own the Schrock Innovations Computer Company. The bathroom break did not interrupt that, I don't think. They didn't sell it while I was gone, did you? 888-250-2091 is the number to join us on the program today. Give us a call, ask a question, make a comment. We'll get you in the drawing. One of the things I want to bring to your attention, guys, for those of you who are among the 4,000-plus people that have subscriptions to our Semantic Endpoint software, this day has been coming. We've talked about it a few times, talked about it more extensively during the after Schrock than during the show, but we have found something better, honestly. For a lot of different reasons. I won't go into all the weed stuff, but the long and the short of it is Symantec sold their security division for corporate security to Broadcom. And Broadcom has been nothing but a nightmare since we came on board. As it stands right now, all customers everywhere on the planet using Endpoint, sold by anybody else, are going to lose their service in the beginning, like the first week of November. Broadcom has a new control panel that we're supposed to migrate everybody into. Doesn't work. Nobody knows why. They have no one you can call for help. There's no online help. There's not even, you press F1, you don't even get that stupid little paperclip guy coming up to help you. And we're like, we're not going to trust the security of our computers or our customers' computers to a company that can't even get a dashboard right. It's just, we're not going to do it. So when Symantec sold the endpoint division to Broadcom, they, of course, created a new company with LifeLock called Norton LifeLock. But you see, the technology under the hood for the latest generation of Norton antivirus products was the same tech they used in endpoint, so they couldn't use it anymore. So that's why they went back to Norton 360 with LifeLock. That was their big product before the current version, and that was the 2015 version, and they replaced it so that they could have something that did better with ransomware. So I'll let you decide if you should run Norton LifeLock or not. But in the meantime, given everything we're seeing, this ransomware on Android phones that's out now, this isn't a joke anymore, guys. This is changing people's lives here. This is really bad. Microsoft warns of Android ransomware that activates when you press the home button on your phone. So just don't press the home button, and you'll be fine, right? The new MalLockB ransomware is currently spreading via online forums and third-party websites. Now, normally, I wouldn't even bring you this story because there are literally dozens of these a week, of these scary-sounding stories that are going to impact virtually nobody. This one is super scary because you have to install the, well, it's scary because it's malware, but it doesn't actually encrypt anything. It just blocks access to it on your phone. But the thing about it is to get this on your phone, you can't get it from the Play Store. You have to install an app from a third-party website somewhere. So nobody does that. You can do that on Androids, but none of our listeners really do that. A few might play with it with an old phone and see what happens. There are websites out there that say basically you can get a deal, if you will, on apps. And the deal is they're free or they're stolen. They're usually infected with something when you get them. And so right now with Fortnite being banned from just about every store on the planet because of the tax payment thing or the payment of fees, a lot of people are going online to other third-party sources to get the latest Fortnite app to install it on their phones without having to go through the Play Store. That is how you get this ransomware. That is how this happens. When the day comes that people start doing that in mass, this is going to become a real big problem. So basically, you're not going to get it from the Play Store. If you don't do those kind of things, you're going to be fine. But if you have a kid who plays Fortnite on a phone and he's like, Mom, I just need to go to this website and download this APK app thing and put it on my phone, put it on an SD card. Do you have an SD card I can borrow? Yeah, that's like the, if you hear that, the antenna should go up. Like, what's happening here? Because the phone's going to get infected. But with all that going on right now, the fact is Symantec Endpoint just does not stop ransomware. It just doesn't. It tries to stop it from getting into the computer, but if it gets in, it's not smart enough to know. Gee whiz, the human being sitting here isn't opening and closing 500 files a second and changing their contents entirely as it's doing it. This might be an automated ransomware attack, and maybe we should stop it. So one of the really cool things that we found with a new product called Sophos, there are two different tiers. I want to be really clear about this. There is the residential, the home tier, and then there's the pro tier. The home tier does everything Symantec Endpoint does, but it also has advanced ransomware detection. The professional tier, which costs more, which we don't have pricing set up for the professional tier yet, we're going to get everybody on the home tier first, so they have the same thing they have with Endpoint first. Then we'll talk about upgrading later. But the home tier, or the professional tier, actually will replace files that got encrypted after they got encrypted. If UIMC would have had this software in place when they got attacked, they would not have gone down. That's how good this stuff is. It is more expensive. We are not making as much money. We're not raising the price, but we're not making as much money on it. But it's better software and it's better protection. And I always told you, if there's something better that came along, we would use it. And this is better. So the good news here is we have an automatic update utility. We're going to put it in a final test on Monday. It's tested individually great on computers. Monday we're going to test it on a bunch of our internal machines. If it works good there, we're going to push that out through Secure Updater. So Monday and Tuesday, if you're a Secure Updater subscriber, you'll notice your endpoint software disappearing and being replaced with Sophos. Don't freak out. That's us. We're doing it. We're just doing it so butter smooth that you don't have to do jack. You don't have to call us. You don't have to have a code. You don't have to click a link. You don't have to do anything. So if you have Secure Updater, I'm going to tell you in the next segment what you need to do to make sure that that's up and running, because that's how you're going to get the automatic upgrade from Endpoint to Sophos. Otherwise, you got to do a bunch of manual stuff. It won't be hard, but it won't be fun. All right, 888-250-2091. David, Monica, I know you're waiting. Stay on the line. Your calls, I promise, are coming up next on Compute This.
Schrock Innovations repair technicians also make house calls. Make an appointment and let us bring our award-winning computer support right to your home or business. Schrock Innovations has spent nearly two decades working to make your technology life easier. And the all-new SchrockInnovations.com is no exception. Now you can order new modular computers and solid-state laptops directly from our website. Secure your computer with our virus-free guaranteed Symantec Endpoint software. Find innovative new technologies like our modular storage devices and get free help and tips. Take a look at the specials section to find sales on one-of-a-kind items, display models, refurbished units, and our latest
special offers. Swing by the Compute This page to watch TV segments and archive radio shows, or even get one-on-one help through the Schrock Desk. As always, we respect your privacy, so we secure our website with the latest encryption technology and only the most secure payment methods. You can pick up your purchases at any of our three service centers or have them shipped directly to your door. The new ShrockInnovations.com makes technology simple. It's what we do. Compute This Pro Tip 843. Of all computer failures, the scariest and most expensive is the hard drive. But there are some steps you can take to save money and save your data before it's too late. Detecting failures early is important, so install a free utility like Drive Advisor from driveadvisor.com to monitor your hard drive's health and receive warnings when there's a problem. But most of all, hard drive failures happen slowly, so early detection is key to reducing the repair bill. Second, if your hard drive makes any unusual noises, immediately turn off your computer and do not turn it on again. These issues are physical problems, and the more you try to use it, the worse the damage becomes. Remember that most computer repair shops do not have the specialized equipment needed to recover data from a failed drive. Never open your drive or allow anyone else to do so. Opened drives always cost more to recover. Schrock does not charge for data recovery evaluations and quotes, so let the local pros look at your drive before you make any recovery decisions. This pro tip brought to you by Schrock Innovations Computer Company.
News. I'm Karen McHugh. Political protesting turned deadly Saturday in Denver. The chief of police describing the moments leading up to the gunfire.
There was a verbal altercation that transpired. Firearm was discharged. Individual was shot and later pronounced deceased. There were two guns recovered at the scene.
Joe Montoya, a suspect, was arrested but then released. After spurning this week's proposed virtual debate, a supporter of President Trump says he still wants to face off against Joe Biden.
The president wants, of course, he wants to debate Joe Biden. He wants to debate him in person. That's what a debate is all about. Not looking at a teleprompter, not reading cue cards, which is what Joe Biden would be doing from his basement.
Florida Attorney General Pam Bondi on Fox and Friends. There's one more scheduled for October 22nd. America is listening to Fox News.
Now, the News Radio 1110 KFAB Weather Watch.
Partly cloudy, windy, and warm today with highs topping out in the mid-80s. We will see winds gusting from the south 35 to 40 miles per hour. Chance for some storms, some of which could be on the strong side after about 7 p.m. Those push out early Monday morning. With Omaha's most accurate forecast, I'm 6 News First Alert Meteorologist Mallory Schnell on News Radio 1110 KFAB.
Alrighty guys, welcome back into Compute This. My name is Thor Schrock. I'm the owner of the Schrock Innovations Computer Company. We have four service centers to help you out when your computers are having problems, but what you might not know is that we do a lot more than just fix computers. As I mentioned earlier in the show, we have a story coming up in the next segment about how one company's new tech is going to make our desktop computers, our modular PCs, 26% faster. That's coming out on November 15th. We're super excited. We haven't tested it yet. We haven't done anything yet, but we know it's going to work because this company, this is how they roll. This is why we use their tech in every single modular computer, because it makes it upgradable. And it's awesome. So, I mean, we have just these amazing things going on, and it just it gets me all excited and worked up. So sometimes I forget things or get mixed up on my schedule here, so I don't want to forget before we go to the phones here to take David and Monica's call to tell you that at Schrock we do some other stuff too. We build those new computers. We also do website design and development. Now, that's what we used to call it, website design and development. Now it's more marketing consulting. And so, you know, for example, the way that this works is if you have a business and you're trying to figure out, there's so much technology out there. And we're going to have a story coming up on the show here, this segment, about a company that literally used technology to transform their business. And you want to do the same thing. You want to at least, maybe not radically transform everything, but at least get moving in the direction of improving through technology. And so what we do is we'll sit down and do a 30-minute business consultation, like a business strategy meeting, where I learn about your business. You meet with me, and then that's there as well on the phone, you know, just to make sure, you know, we're all staying on task and we don't start joking about, you know, politics or something, and then, you know, 2 hours later say, okay, anyway, back to the point, because you know that would happen sometimes with some business owners. like me. What was I talking about again? Oh, yeah, that's right. See, it just happened again. No, the... No, and so during this business strategy meeting, I get to understand more about your company, and I ask you some questions about your stuff, like, who's your target demographic? What are you trying to do? You know, what are you selling? What is your competitive advantage? You would be surprised how many business owners who have been doing things for years don't know, or they have a platitude, like, it's our service. What about your service? So, for example, we got this story here with McDonald's about how they bought a little tech company. The headline is, McDonald's used tech to get better. Chick-fil-A customers just laughed. That's the headline. So basically, McDonald's bought this tiny little company. There was a little tech company, and right at the onset of the pandemic, it was called C-Level HX. And what this company did is, if you probably have noticed that McDonald's has new menu boards outside in the drive-thru, those menu boards are more than just a giant TV screen. There's an entire algorithm deciding what to put on the menu board, what time of day to put it on the menu board, which sports team won the game to put it on the menu board, or what are we out of to not put on the menu board? What's in shortage due to pandemic so we don't put that on the menu board? So here we have McDonald's. And, you know, for years, McDonald's has been in decline, right? I mean, let's just be straight about it. McDonald's was never exactly the super healthy place to go. The inventor of supersizing, right? That they came up with that. Supersize me, you know, they did. But getting a bigger drink and more fries, or getting that milkshake, that was McDonald's go-to. They were a burger, shake, fry, fast food, greasy, fry the fries in beef oil because it's delicious kind of place to go. Well, then we have to get healthy, and we go get rid of the beef oil, and now my fries don't taste the same. We tell my son, oh, I wish you were alive 20 years ago. You could have had McDonald's fries. They would have blown your mind. They taste kind of like Freddy's fries, except they're thicker, you know? And it's like, if you've been to Freddy's, you taste their fries. They're delicious. So they're not healthy, but they're delicious, right? That's why you're going there. So during the pandemic, McDonald's, they had to go simple. They had to scale down their menu. They had to get rid of the fancy salads and the mochaccinos and all this other garbage, because they're getting wider, not deeper. We're going to introduce more products and more products to appeal to an ever-widening number of people, because people just don't want to eat fattening burgers and fries anymore. Newsflash, heck yeah. Everybody wants to eat fattening burgers and fries. Now, maybe we can't every day because we're getting fat, but yeah, you're still going to do it from time to time. It's good stuff. Okay? It used to be anyway. So McDonald's had this problem in their drive-thru where it was taking a long time to get through the drive-thru. So they simplified their menu down to their core offerings during the pandemic, and then they used these screens to basically make your order faster. So the amount of time, have you ever pulled up to the McDonald's drive-thru and then thought, what do I want? And like, you're looking at the board like, And you know, you might spend 10 seconds looking at the board. Well, they shaved 40 seconds off the drive-thru time, and that's where 10 of it came from. Because they're showing you stuff on the board based on all kinds of factors in the algorithm. It would not surprise me if they knew your license plate number to show you what you ordered last time. Because let's be honest, you're going to get the number 4. It's going to happen again. So in the meantime, the rest of the headline I thought was funny, because I'm like, Chick-fil-A customers just laughed. Why is this? So I scroll clear down to the end of this article about how McDonald's used this cool technology. And it says, may I present Chick-fil-A? According to the survey, the chain is absolutely the slowest when it comes to drive-thru speed. Chick-fil-A blows at drive-thru speed. It was the slowest in 2019. It was the slowest in 2018. They're not getting better. Yet the survey doesn't just measure speed. It looks at accuracy, customer service, and taste. In every single category aside from speed, Chick-fil-A was number one. In essence, for all McDonald's success in bringing down service times, speed is only part of the equation. So, right, so this is a great example of a company that did something really cool with tech, right? There is somebody at McDonald's doing the happy dance in the boardroom because the drive-thru is faster. And there's somebody else at McDonald's saying, why our numbers are not going up, where numbers need to go. Now, they did have the best quarter they've had, like, ever when they were, you know, this last quarter. But, you know, what's going on here? Our numbers are hurting. We need to improve the customer experience. Didn't we just do that? It's not the whole thing. So if you have a business consultation meeting, we sit down and figure out the whole thing, the whole enchilada, and say, what are we trying to accomplish? What page on your website does this? Do you have a specific function for every page on your website? Most people don't. You should. Do you have statistics? You should. So we do a lot of other things at Schrock as well. One of the things that we also do at Schrock is we take phone calls. 888-250-2091. David, thank you so much for your patience. How can I help you today on Compute This?
Yeah. Hi, Thor.
Good morning.
I'm glad you're kind of... I'm glad you're still a small-town approach here. Don't forget the little guy.
Oh, no, not at all. You're over in the Papillion area, right?
So, well, I went to that store because it's closest to me.
Okay.
And I a great experience on the phone and in person. I'll name names if I have to or if I can.
Oh, go for it. Yeah, we love it.
Yeah, so Jacob was top-notch. I'm sold. This is my first visit. I've been listening to you, but I hadn't done anything. First thing you did is save me some money, but I know I'll go and spend there later.
Sure.
The Android VPN.
Yeah.
Is this something that's gonna hog on my memory? I don't have the newest phone. Is it gonna work? Do I have to buy a new phone if I'm going to do this Android VPN? How does this really
sure.
happen for me?
Well, what I did is I purchased ExpressVPN. An ExpressVPN, it was something like $30 or $40 for the entire year or something like that. But then I can run it on my laptop. I can run it on my desktop. And the reason that I purchased it originally, this is going to make you laugh. My wife loves that show Heartland, the Canadian horse show, you know, except they release it in Canada a year before they release it in the United States. So if you're watching the public broadcast company in Canada, you can watch the current season of Heartland. And there are people who will record it with a camcorder and post it to YouTube or record it with a camcorder. What am I, Joe Biden with my record player? You know, they're going to record it with their smartphone and then, sorry, it just fell out. It happens. And then they're going to post it on YouTube and then YouTube has to take it down. The funny thing is if you're in Canada, you can actually just watch the show online on their website, on the broadcast company's website. So guess what? You get a VPN, you set your location to Canada, suddenly your computer's in Canada and you can watch whatever you want. Same thing for all the BBC shows as well. Now you're in England, you can do whatever you want to do. So that's why I got it originally, and I have it installed on my computers. I don't honestly turn it on very often because it's really a pain in the butt for e-commerce, and I do a lot of the ordering of parts for the company. So if I'm in random locations all the time around the country, like this morning I'm in Dallas and then this afternoon I'm in Phoenix, it screws. I get a lot of security checks, orders that don't process, things like that. I've had it installed on my phone now, to as I explained, to get around a newspaper paywall. I installed it on my phone. And their paywall is very good, actually. You also have to go incognito and use a VPN. It's pretty crazy. But it has not slowed my phone down a single bit. Every single app on my phone runs through the VPN now. It is amazing. I'm like, I don't, and it stays running all the time. So now, like, not even my, when I'm at home on my Wi-Fi, not even Cox knows what I'm doing with my phone, what apps I'm opening. I mean, Sprint still might because they provide the service, but in theory, it should even be hidden from them. So it's pretty amazing, honestly. And I'm kind of regretting I hadn't done it sooner, to be honest. We don't sell VPNs, so like I said, I'm using ExpressVPN. Sophos does make a VPN that we can integrate into the endpoint antivirus software, which is one of the big reasons we're moving to Sophos. They have so many options, but right now, we're not thinking about that. I'm just thinking VPN is the way to go. It's awesome. Thanks for the call, David. I appreciate it. Real quick, before we take a break here, let's take Monica's call. Monica, you've been patient. I really appreciate it. How can I help you on Compute This? Monica, are you there? Oh, no, we have a bad cell, I think. Let's put Monica back on hold. Monica, we're going to come back to you after the break to see if you're in an area where maybe where there's a little bit better signal. But when we come back, oh, boy, we've got the story, the stock tip that is going. If you still have anything left in your Robinhood account, I mean, have you hear about Robinhood? People are getting their money stolen out of their Robinhood account, and because Robinhood has no customer service department, like, there's no one you can call. Like, they're watching their money being, their stocks get liquidated. This is like if you had your E-Trade account and your stocks get liquidated, and then someone starts transferring the money out of your account into their account. and you can't stop it. You can't lock your account. You can't stop all transactions. You can't do a thing. You're locked out, and you can't call anybody for help. And it's, oh my gosh, it's happened to like several people apparently, and it's so much so that the SEC is looking into it. So if you have any money left in your Robinhood account, we've got a stock tip for you about the technology that's going to make not only Schrock's modular computers 26% faster before the end of the year, but they are going to absolutely dominate their market. They already had a heck of a run from $20 to about $80 in their stock price. So I'm not a financial advisor, guys, but if I was you, I'd throw a little money into this company. We're going to tell you who they are coming up next on Compute This.
Update all of your third-party apps on your computer with Secure Updater. It keeps all your apps running smoothly and helps block viruses. Download it for free today at secureupdater.com. Some people like desktops for their power and upgradability, but nothing rivals a laptop for computing on the go. But why should you have to sacrifice performance for portability? The innovators at Schrock want our customers to have it all, so we created a new kind of laptop, the Solid State Laptop from Schrock Innovations. Solid State laptops are built using the same frame and main boards as regular laptops, but we've removed half of the moving parts while more than doubling the computer's speed. The result? Laptops that boot to Windows in 6 seconds or less, respond instantly to your commands, and can survive drops that put most laptops into the data recovery lab. Starting at only $499, solid-state laptops give you speed, reliability, durability, and performance for the same price most people pay for a cheap disposable laptop. The next time you're looking for a laptop, check out the solid-state laptops at schrockinnovations.com or visit any of our service centers. Simple, solid, fast technology is what we do at Schrock. Compute This Pro Tip 578. Technology is constantly changing, so how can you tell when the time has come to recycle your old outdated computer and invest in a new one? Experts have rules of thumb and formulas, but Schrock believes the answer is simple. You should replace your old computer when it can no longer do the things you need in a secure way. For example, you should not be using operating systems like Windows XP or Vista because they're no longer maintained by Microsoft and they're not secure. And if your computer cannot run Windows 10, it's probably time to begin saving for a replacement. If your existing computer requires a repair and that cost is 50% or more of the cost of a new computer, it might be time to consider a replacement. But keep in mind, additional costs like data transfers and important software you have to upgrade, like genealogy software or Quicken. And also keep in mind that modern computers are engineered to last 18 months for a normal user. And don't worry, you are considered a normal user. Schrock modular PCs and solid-state laptops are specifically designed to last 4 to 6 years for that same normal user, saving your family money and time. This pro tip brought to you by Schrock Innovations Computer Company.
Alrighty, guys, final segment of the show. Number to join us on the program, because that's when all you all call is right in the last few minutes here, is 888-250-2091. All right, I want to take a quick moment to tell you about Secure Updater. I promised I would do this here in the program. And I talked a lot about this in the Aftershock last week, because it was a little bit in the weeds. But one of the things, what Secure Updater does, it's a program that we make at Schrock. And what it does is it automatically and silently downloads and installs updates for third-party programs on your computer, like Flash or Java, Adobe Reader, tons of them, VLC Media Player, LibreOffice, you name it, TeamViewer. Tons of programs that we all have on our computer that you might end up waiting up to 14 days to get an update from the maker of the software before they finally push it down to you. Well, that's 14 days where you're living exposed because they didn't make the update because they were bored on a Friday night. They made it because there was a security vulnerability. They're plugging a hole. We want to do that for you. We want to make sure that your computer is safe. We want to seal up those vulnerabilities, plug those holes so that you don't have the problems. So what Secure Updater does is within 8 hours of the release of an update, it downloads and installs the update on your computer. It doesn't do Windows updates. Safe Upgrade is different from Secure Updater. We've had some people recently get confused about that. Safe Upgrade is a program to install one specific Microsoft update that's a big doozy that's coming out here in the next 14 days. Secure Updater is a subscription that runs for a year. And it works on your computer for a year. It's a little over $2 a month. It's really affordable, and it does a great job. Especially if you're not using our endpoint software, you're using a lesser antivirus software. This will help plug those holes, so you don't have the vulnerabilities. So that when you get an infected PDF and you do open it, because you're going to get it, it doesn't infect your computer because that vulnerability in Adobe Reader has been plugged. You see what I'm saying? So one of the things we can do with Sophos is we can deliver you what we're calling the Sophos Migration Manager through Secure Updater. And so what it will do is it's a program that's going to run on every person who has Secure Updater's computer, and it's going to say, does this person have endpoint? And if the answer is yes, is the endpoint something that they purchased from Schrock? And if the answer is yes, then it's going to automatically install Sophos on your computer and then remove the endpoint software from your computer. This is going to start happening next week. It's going to be completely transparent. You won't even know it's happening. Your internet connection is not going to get interrupted. It's not going to be like a big Windows update. The computer will probably want to restart afterward. We're not going to force it to restart. We restart it when you want to restart it. But basically, once everything is taken care of, it's going to pop up a window for our website to explain to you what has happened and why it's happened. It's going to have all the statistics about all the reasons that I don't have time to talk about on the radio that Sophos is better than Symantec's old endpoint software and why we're making the decision to do this. So, of course, if you have a subscription to Endpoint, we have customers who bought it yesterday. You know, we're still selling it until next week because you still need security, but we're going to upgrade you automatically. Yesterday, for example, in the Papillion Service Center, I saw three or four customers who chose to purchase Endpoint but did not purchase Secure Updater. So because you don't have Secure Updater, we can't automatically upgrade you to Sophos. So what's going to happen is you're going to receive a communication from us instructing you to go to our website and click on a link on the website. Never, ever, ever, ever click a link in your email. It's bad secure. It's bad info security. It's going to get you a virus every time. We're not going to send you a link that says click this link to download our program and update your antivirus software. Because if you ever see that, it should be absolutely a scam every time. We will send you something that says please visit schrockinnovations.com and then click on the page about the Sophos migration and click on the link to download the program and run it on your computer. Now, the problem is we have some customers that literally, they're going to see the email, and then that's going to be it. Downloading and installing a program is sometimes a challenge for some people. Sometimes people download it, and they don't remember they have to install it, or they download it, and they don't know where it goes. So we know we're going to have some Schrock desking to do. We know we're going to have some people we're going to have to hold their hands through the migration. We got about a month to do it, so we'll have plenty of time. But my point is if you do subscribe to Secure Updater, please make sure your software is running. I get a report every month about people who have not logged into their Secure Updater account in the last 6 months, and the report's about 300 people every single time. And we send them calls and emails saying, why aren't you logging in? Well, I got a new computer. You know, you can move that subscription from your old computer to your new one. I did not know that. So then we do it for them. So long story short here, guys, I know too late. Make sure your Secure Updater is running. Next week, it's going to be really important. Look in the lower right-hand corner of your screen by your clock. If you see your little Secure Updater shield with a U, that means that you're going to, if you are running Endpoint, you're going to get the update. As long as that's green, you're good to go. If it is red, that means there's an update that needs to be installed that can't be, usually because the program is open. Just reboot the computer. That usually takes care of that. If it's black, that means that you're either not connected to the internet or your subscription is expired. And if it's expired or you're not connected or the password's wrong or any of those things are a problem, please take a look at that this weekend and get that resolved. We are going to be testing this on Monday. We could send this update as soon as Monday because we really don't want this process to overlap with the Microsoft Windows upgrade that's happening, the 2.0H2 update, which is happening at the end of the month. We want to get all these endpoint things migrated before that, if at all possible, because you know darn well if one of these updates from Microsoft goes sideways on a computer that we don't have safe upgrade on, and we did a Sophos migration 2 days before that, you know who's going to get blamed for the computer going sideways, even though it's not the Sophos that did it. We want to avoid that, so we're going to try to get through this quick. Just make sure your Secure Updater is running. All right, let's jump back into the phones. Monica, we're going to try to reach you again here. We had a bad connection there last time. Can you hear us okay?
I sure can.
Perfect. We can hear you too. How can I help you today on Compute This?
Well, my husband's going to start a different job, and we have two Apples. One desktop, one laptop.
Okay.
But they want a PC. So I know that you have a holiday special of $1,400. We can't spend that.
Sure.
Do you have lesser ones there?
Oh, of course. We have laptops all year long for different things. So when you say he's going overseas, what kind of an environment is he going to be in? Like sandy?
Insurance agent.
Oh, when you said overseas, I thought you meant military.
Oh, no.
I thought he's going to the sandbox. I'm like, I thought we were bringing those guys home. Like, wait a minute. So, insurance agent. Okay, so basically there's two different laptops in our lineup that would best suit him because he's going to be using it for like a home office kind of experience. Number one would be our Intrepid laptop, which is our mid-range laptop. That starts at $699. And then if he wants to go a little bit higher, I would recommend it for what he's doing is the Gallant laptop, which is a business-grade laptop. It's $899, but it's got all those stupid little extras. It's got the fingerprint reader for the biometrics. It's got the backlit keyboard. It's got the ultra-bright screen. It's super light, super thin. It's got all of the features that he would be looking for. It'll have more features than the current Mac does, for sure. I'm not going to try to convert you because I know you're buying the PC out of necessity rather than desire. But once you experience what the PC can do over and above what the Mac can do and how inexpensive it is in comparison to a Mac, you might become a believer. That's all I'm saying. But yes, one of those two laptops is what I would recommend.
Well, I have an old PC downstairs. It says Lenovo.
Uh-huh.
That's the brand, I guess. It says ThinkPad.
Yeah.
But it stopped 2 months ago. And I was just wondering, is that something we could revive, or have you heard of that brand at all?
Oh, yeah, Lenovo. They used to be owned by AMD. By IBM, three different letters. And then they sold them. Now they're a Chinese company. And so it's like a Huawei, basically. So they're actually technologically really nice laptops. Till they break, when they do break, if you physically break them, you need a palm rest or a back or something, or a screen. They're really tough to get. But from a running standpoint, they're a fine computer. In fact, if it just won't turn on, like, when you hit the power button, does it just...
No, we don't know. I just don't know. It just won't turn on. And I don't know if it's done for or if it can be revived.
Have you ever been to our service centers before for anything?
No. I listen to your show practically every Sunday because you guys sure know what you're doing. And I thought, well, maybe someday I'll need you guys, and today's the Sunday.
Well, it sounds good. Thank you. I appreciate you listening every week. Now, one of the things I would recommend is, if you've been listening every week, you probably know this. The first hour of labor is always free for new customers. So why don't you bring that Lenovo into one of our service centers, let us take a look at it and get you a quote on what it's going to take to fix it, and then if it proves to be too expensive, we can always look at a different computer at that point. We do keep them in stock for you, so that's doable that way. Thanks for the call. We appreciate it there. Congratulations, Donald. You are the winner of the $25 Schrock Innovations gift certificate. We didn't quite get to your call here on air. I'll try to take it here off the air in just a moment. AMD is coming out with a new chip that will easily upgrade into the existing modular computer. It is going to destroy all of Intel's lineup all over again, and it's the same silicon as before. No increased production costs. Check out that AMD stock in a pop. See you next week.
Fueled by Hy-Vee, home of hot deals and hundreds of price declines. This is News Radio 1110 KFAB, Omaha, and iHeart Radio Station.